Hi guys, this is Retired the Dead from the Mondo Squalido channel. This time we're doing an in-depth look of a more recent release from the same company as the guys who released the absolutely fantastic edition of the opening of Misty Beethoven. It is of course Distribpix, and it is their release of Barbara Broadcast. Now we're going to be looking at the 3-disc edition where you get 1 Blu-ray and 2 DVDs, and boy are you guys in for a treat. Before I start, again, I haven't actually got around to watching the film yet, so I won't be commenting on the film, but I will be doing a Mondo Squalido review of the film in the very, very, very near future, so please look out for that. If you're watching this before seeing the review, if it's already uploaded, it will be in the comments, or the description I should say, for you to check out if you so wish. So, as you can clearly tell by the title and the introduction, we are looking at Barbara Broadcast, another Henry Paris classic. So without any further ado, I'll stop talking and we'll get straight on with what this edition looks like. Once again, this release comes in a slipcase edition. It is, of course, in a Blu-ray case underneath, but it does house 2 DVDs and a Blu-ray, which we will look at in a little bit. But first, let's have a quick scan of the artwork. Once again, Distribpix come up with the goods when it comes to the artwork. It might not be as extravagant as the Misty Beethoven artwork, but it's still fantastic nonetheless. Really, really simple. You've got the knife and the fork with the plate there. Absolutely great stuff. An erotic film in 4 courses. So there's the front. Quickly look at the spine, which again is delightfully simple. And then on the other side, which is upside down, how very professional of me, it's pretty much the same. And then on the back, you've got some shots of the film, you've got the synopsis, and I'm not going to talk about them right now, but holy crap do you get a hell of a lot of special features across the 3 discs. And as you can clearly see, it is mapped out as if it was a menu. Once again, I do apologise for the light and the fact that you can see my camera and my fat finger. But hopefully, again, that doesn't detract from it. Of course, this video is doing this release no justice whatsoever. But you can see high quality scans if you go onto Google Images and onto the Distribpix website itself. But in the flesh, this looks absolutely fantastic. And that's just the slipcase. So if you just bear with me a second, guys, I'll show you what it actually looks like on the Blu-ray case itself. Not going to spend too much time on this because, as you can clearly tell, it's the same artwork on the slipcase. But once again, even if this edition was just to come in the Blu-ray case itself, it still looks absolutely fantastic. On the back, it's pretty much the same. And again, likewise with the sleeve. But overall, really happy with the artwork on this release. Once again, if you'd have a poster of this, it would look absolutely fantastic. So that's what it looks like on the outside. Will it have inside artwork on like the Misty Beethoven release? We'll just have to wait and see. No, this isn't an insert, this is actually the sleeve. As you can see, we have inner artwork. I took it out of the case so you could see it properly. Of course, we've got the legendary Dennis Parker, aka Wade Nichols. And the equally legendary CJ Lang. And of course, this film is famous for their scene, which I'm sure I will absolutely love because I am a massive Wade Nichols fan. But anyway, I'm not here to talk about that. I'm just here to show you what the inside artwork looks like. And if you just bear with me for a second, guys, I'll show you what the disc artwork is like. On the first DVD, this is what the artwork looks like. Really nice and simple, nice colour scheme with the logo at the top. Then on the second disc, we've got a bit of a naughtier image, which I'm not too fussed about. I'm not too fussed about showing, I should say. Of course, that's a really nice image. And then, of course, on the Blu-ray, we have got the same similar artwork as the front cover, and I apologize for my terrible English throughout this video, my mind is mashed. But yeah, really nice job with the discs. So that's what the artwork throughout looks like. Let's have a look at what the special features of the discs are. So on the discs themselves, on the Blu-ray, you've got the hard uncut version. It comes with a director's commentary, theatrical trailer, slideshow and ephemera, I hope I'm saying that right. You also get film facts, radio spot, and look at that. Just absolutely fantastic to see the amount of detail and time and effort that's gone into the restoration of this film. Absolutely fantastic. Then of course on DVD 1 we also get a DVD version of the hard version, which also comes with the director's commentary. We get a making of, actor interview, film facts, and on DVD 2 you get the soft version, a tribute to the players, trailers and outtakes, slides and ephemera, and also original radio spots. So as you can see, on the Blu-ray you get the main feature, and then on the DVDs you get the same HD features but spread across the DVDs, and also some more content, which if you're a fan of this film, this is of course the definitive edition of this film to get. But if, like me, you want to experience this film the way it should be, this is again a great release with a whole wealth of special features. And as you can see there, you get some extensive liner notes, which brings me on to the supplemental material. Just like the Misty Beethoven release, you get the typical flyers promoting the film, promoting Misty Beethoven, the films of Henry Paris and Distribpix. Of course, you get a healthy sized booklet, so there's a lot to chew on there, excuse the pun. Of course, you get photos in there, liner notes, writings on the film, on the restoration, on the people involved. Absolutely fantastic, as always, with the booklets that you get in Distribpix releases. But wait, there's even more. One of the things that you get is this absolutely fantastic art card. You also get what I assume is a bookmark. And just like the Misty Beethoven release, you get a really cool little fridge magnet. Although, I don't really think that's going to go well on the family fridge, but it's still a really nice addition nonetheless. So once again, Distribpix just put so much time and effort in their releases. And there you have it, ladies and gents, Barbara Broadcast, the Blu-ray and DVD combo from Distribpix. Once again, Distribpix are stuffing you to the brim with content, with restoration. It's a real nice collector's piece. There's a lot to sink your teeth into, and I'm sure that this video will at least whet your appetites enough to at least check out more information about the film and Distribpix themselves. As always, links will be down below to where you can purchase this, as well as links to Distribpix all over the web. And any related videos that I can find, I will put them in the description as well. But what can I say, guys? Distribpix have done it again. Barbara Broadcast, the Blu-ray and 2DVD combo. Absolutely stunning release. And watch soon for a review on Mondo Squalido. So if you've got this release, or if you've got any questions, feel free to ask or give me your thoughts. And until the next time, guys, you're all awesome.